Hey guys!
Hey guys!
How are you? Welcome back!
So we just wanted to kind of do things a little bit different and just talk with you, you know? Just like kind of talk as if like we're with you, but we can't be because COVID. You know, I feel like on TikTok, it's just like a little glimpse of like actually who we are as people. And
it's just very much little parcels of who we are, but it's true that we've been missing maybe a bit more communication and like really talk to you guys about us and who we are
and our thoughts and just
in our stories.
Yeah, exactly. So I think right now the biggest topic of conversation is
my age. Yes, I'm 30.
Wow.
Yes.
Groundbreaking.
I know. Yes, I'm proud of my age. I don't have any problem with it. Although, you know, we probably all think that the best years of our lives are the young years. I think it's a common thought, right?
But anyway, I feel like, wait, just to correct you there, there's like a misconception that 30 is old or not young.
This is...
Guys, wait.
30, you're a baby when you're 30. Let me tell you. But the thing is that you don't realize that until you're much older.
Yes, this is what I want to say. Because I'm 25 years old. I probably resonate, just based off my age, a little bit more with people who are 18, 19, 20. Because it seems closer to you. I remember being 18, 19, and 20. And thinking, oh my god, like 25, like that's so far away. Guys, it flies by like that, and then you become 25, and you're like, holy crap, I still feel exactly how I felt when I was 18, you know? So I'm just saying, like, you have to understand, and a lot of people do this too, that are younger and like around 18, 19, 20, is they're so desperate to grow up, and they're so desperate, get older, and I'm like, guys, enjoy every second.
Enjoy it.
Yeah.
And the thing is that, okay, you're an adult at 21, right? That's when you're an adult, technically.
Well, you're of age at 18.
You're of age of 18,
so technically, then, yeah.
Legal
for legal everything
at 21.
Yeah. In America.
So kind of an adult.
Yeah.
And you're an adult for the rest of your life since 21. The thing is that, you know, it's very different what you look on the outside, or like what is your age on your passport, or how people see you. It's very different on the outside than on the inside. Mm-hmm. All right. And the thing is that most of the time inside, let me tell you, you never really grow old inside. Even when you're 60, I have long conversations with my mom, and she's 70 today, and your age is just like we were saying, is the amount of time you went around the moon.
No, around the sun. Around the sun. You don't even know what you're talking about.
And
you lose your memory. No, I'm kidding.
No. That doesn't mean, I'm on the moon all the time, that's why I say that. But like, so around the sun, it's just, it doesn't reflect who you are on the inside. Mm-mm. You might be 90 years old and still feel like a young man inside. That doesn't mean you're gonna be a pedophile. That doesn't mean you're gonna, you know, I'm not saying anything like that, of course. That doesn't make any sense.
You're referring to the age doesn't matter thing.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Life is complicated. Things are complicated. Things are hard.
And also
things, it's not.
Journeys are very, like, we were just talking about this today with our manager. Like, success and also life and everything is like this. Like,
yeah,
nothing is like a straight path.
Nothing is black or white.
And I think, listen,
you're gonna learn with life to deal with the fact that everything is always mm-hmm. a balance of everything. It's nothing is black and white ever. You're always gonna be in a gray area for everything.
Yeah.
And nothing is that easy as just an age on your passport, a gender mm-hmm. on your passport, a color of hair on your passport. No, you are who you decide to be on the inside. Mm-hmm. You are who you're making yourself, mm-hmm. who you work and strive in your life to be, your because one day you're an asshole doesn't mean that the next day you're not gonna try to be a better person, you know? And it's everything changes, everything evolves, everything is fluid. Evolving,
yeah.
So to put on ourselves stickers that will never change or that is very strict, like all the stickers, doesn't make any sense because humans are very fluid. Humans are free. Humans are free of to be whoever they want to be and whoever, whatever makes them happy.
Mm-hmm.
If I want to feel young, if I want to have fun, and yes, if I feel like sometime being an adult suck and I want to just cherish
your youth,
my youth a little bit more, or like, I'm free to do that.
Yeah.
Because...
And you shouldn't feel afraid to do that either.
Yes.
No matter how old you are. Obviously, we're speaking in terms of being of age and, like, you know, I think there's a misconception. We're not talking about being in a relationship or having relationships with people. We're talking about just being, you know, young-spirited. And,
yeah.
You know, just because he's 30 or I'm 25 doesn't mean we have to act a certain way. Obviously, we have responsibilities that an 18-year-old doesn't have. An 18-year-old doesn't have. But that doesn't mean that you have to be, like, a grandpa. You know what I mean?
No.
And also, I think also there's a huge misconception about Pierre and that he acts like a child. Like, guys, Pierre is this way in real life. Like, I cannot emphasize that enough.
Let me tell you, in my life, you know, and it's very important to say that because in my life, I've been like that all my life, all right? And... people have called me slow. People have called me like, oh, he's the weird one, or he's acting like...
And said you have like, you know...
weird.
He shamed you. Yeah.
You know, sometimes you're ashamed for who you are, or you just... sometimes it's not your best asset, you know, to be who you are. Sometimes you're bullied for it. Sometimes you may be a bit too bright for people. Maybe you're a bit too colorful for people. You know, you're never going to please anyone. The thing is that who I am, I have to own it. And yes, I might be a bit slow. Yeah, I might be a bit acting like a child. That's who I am. And
it's true.
And
that's one of the reasons I have to say I fell in love with Pierre, is that he was not like any other person I had met. Like, I feel like every person I had met was either jaded or, you know, lost their sparkle, like how they view the world, like they lost that kind of like hope and that imaginary, you know, like, you know, dreams. They lost their dreams. Mm-hmm. When I met Pierre, it was like anything is possible. We can be whoever we want. We can do whatever we want. And I have somebody like me, because I'm similar to that I dream big. I want big, and I see big. And I found someone who does that too, and who doesn't see, you know, the crappy stuff of life. Like, he sees the sugar-coated sweetness.
Let me be honest. I see it, and I've seen it all. I've seen a lot of it. I came here when I was 18. I came here in America with nothing. I came here to find myself.
Tell them the maybe story, to, you know? Like, yeah. You know, what you were doing when you first came here.
Yeah. So I came here with nothing to follow my dreams. I was kind of trying to go away from... friends and what my family could think about my sexuality and what my friends could think about who I am. And I was trying to just go away and live my dreams. And I came here with no money. So it's been more than 10 years ago now, when I was 18. And the first job I could get was just to clean into a hostel, because that's the hostel where I used to stay. And they told me, listen, if you try to stay in America, you can clean the hostel for free. So I was cleaning the bathrooms, the rooms, everything, to stay there for free. Let me tell you, that was the most beautiful spiritual travel I did, because to see people with nothing trying to make it here in America, coming here with nothing, having nothing, and technically just their dreams in their pockets, and still having a smile on their faces, and keep going and having all the hopes in the world for their future, is the most powerful thing, because sometime when we're a bit privileged, or more, when we're lucky enough to have more privilege, we tend to forget that actually happiness is just to have your belly full, have your dreams in your heart, and be in good health. And that's the most important things of all. And I've learned that all through those years, those 10 years of work, hard work. I was a waiter, I did all the jobs possible. Sometime I had to sleep outside, because let me tell you, that was probably my fault. I just did not organize myself well enough to not do that.
I told you, he's aloof.
Most of the time it's just, but I went through those things, and along the way I met wonderful people. I met also people that did not make it, was not lucky enough to stay away from dangerous stuff, like, you know,
bad influences.
Mm-hmm. And we're not all able to make it, but along that way I've learned a lot of things. And yes, being an adult is not always pretty. It's far to be pretty. It's far to be light and you know, all happiness all the time. And it's true that part of me, maybe as I grew older, did not want to see all this. And it's true that the best years of my life always will be my childhood. It's true. Before I came out, before I even knew what I was going to have to go through with my sexuality and all this. And it's true that when you're, you know, living with your parents that are happy, that are not divorced yet, or that are not, maybe it is the best years of your life. And maybe there's a part of me that want to stay at that moment of my life, because life is not all beautiful. And you know, okay, I could be like, face it, like, don't be yourself anymore, don't hide behind your dreams and all that, but fuck it, no, I will hide behind my dreams, I will not hide, I will just own my dreams, I will be the person I want to be, because I want to keep dreaming, I want to keep having my dreams. I don't care how hard life is, I don't care how people want to pull you to the bottom, I don't care about all this. I've seen all this, I know all this, I do. But at the end of the day, if you have the courage to say, fuck it, I'll be who I am, and I'll keep on dreaming, well, that makes me happy. And if that's all I have, I will keep on doing it, you know, till I'm 90. Yeah, so that's the way I see life, and that's the way I see things. And yeah, that's it's funny. No, but it's true. Honestly, if there's things I can say through my experiences, you know, things get dirty. Don't lose your identity. Don't. Things get worse, and sometimes things are very hard. For the sake of anything, just don't lose your identity. Don't lose your dreams. Don't lose all this.
Don't lose your sparkle, you know? Yeah, don't exactly. Lose the thing that makes you shine. Because mm-hmm. There's going to be so many things in this world and in your path that will want to dim that shine. And
everything all the time.
All the time.
It will feel like a fight every day. Yeah. It is a fight every day.
And you really, really got to hold on to that. Because I'm telling you, that's what's going to keep you pushing on and being strong and loving life. Mm-hmm. If you don't have that, it can get bad.
Yes, because if you don't have your dreams and your identity or your heart, what do you have left? Nothing, technically.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe a bit of money, maybe a bit of
success. Yeah,
success.
But the thing is, those things temporarily fill a void, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And when those run out, and they will, what are you going to have to fall back on? And that's when you have to know That's like why loving yourself and loving who you are and your sparkle mm-hmm. is so important. And not letting people, you know, bully you to not have those things.
Mm-hmm.
And we weren't, Pierre was never bullied in this situation. I know we haven't been posting a lot on TikTok. It's just because it's the holiday. We're taking a little bit of a break, you know?
Yeah, we're just enjoying our
life today, you know?
And Christmas and all this.
We're still here. And mm-hmm. that's also another reason, guys, why, you know, I don't like to make our content, I like to keep it really lighthearted. We both do. Because that's our vision in life. It's like
because life is a big joke.
You know?
Let me tell you. It's a fucking joke. It's a sad joke. But sometimes it's gotta stay light.
Yeah.
Because if you... There's nothing, like you say, like, there's nothing more fun than something light. That something where you don't think about all the realities of things, but you just focus on simple things.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah.
So yeah, guys, that's our first little vent.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, we can keep going.
Yeah?
Yes, no. tell us about
your life. No, it's alright. It's already been 16 minutes.
Oh, wow.
We're on for a minute.
Oh my God. Okay.
But we'll do another video
soon. I talked a lot. Yes. Also, put in your comments, like, what would you like to know about us?
Yeah.
What would you like to know about our story?
Yeah.
I want you to tell us about your story.
Yes, of course, of course, of course. But I think it's very important for them to hear from you and your story, because it's very, very inspirational.
Yes. And again, don't take this this video like I'm responding to anything.
No, yeah.
Because the thing is that anybody that makes a video about the way I look, the way we look, our age, my age,
what we've done to ourselves, our personal choices.
Yes, I'm 30, so now you all know it.
I'm 25.
And I don't take things that seriously anymore.
Yeah, yeah.
I think that as long as creators can have fun with that and make videos, I laugh at a lot of them, to be honest. I think it's funny. I think it's a lot of them are cute, you know. And come on, we're all in the same boat.
Yeah,
we're all out here struggling to survive, literally survive.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not gonna blame anybody to, you know, do their things. Everything's respectable.
Mm-hmm.
I respect everything, and let's keep doing all this fun stuff.
Totally. And also, guys, like, I don't know, there's a lot of like things going around out there about, you know, rumors about us or what we have done or may have not done, or
cosmetic stuff.
And stuff. And like, listen, at the end of the day, I have owned everything that I have ever chose to do, and so is Pierre.
Absolutely. And oh my God, yes.
And I think I just want to put it out here, because I don't really care to get into it. We've already done many videos about this in the past. It's at the end of the day, it's my personal choice. It's Pierre's personal choice. We did it for ourselves. It's what made us happy. It hurt nobody. Mm-hmm. And I don't think you should ever feel ashamed for doing something for yourself.
No.
Just gonna leave that there.
Yes. Yeah. Yes, guys. You know, even if I did all the things that they say out there, if I graft my nose and all this, guys, that should not be a big deal.
I've never even heard of that, to be honest.
Oh, really?
Your nose,
yes, they think my nose is fake. And so, guys, it's fine. Yes, even if I did all the things that they say I did, it should be fine.
Yeah.
You know, we should be able to reflect who we want to be. This is the base of everything. If we feel different on the inside and we want to be... reflect something else on the outside, that is fine.
Yeah, and guys, obviously it's never, I don't know if it will ever change. I'm just saying, for our little community, us, me, Pierre, and all of you that watch, that actually enjoy our videos and our content, let's keep it a judge-free zone. Like, this is a zone where you can be whoever you want. Love and respect who you are, who you're presenting to me when I see you. That's who I love and respect. I don't care what you've done. You gotta love yourself, and I will love you, and he will love you. And none of this matters. We're just let's just be thankful we're alive. You know, there's many people suffering this year, suffering, and we're just nitpicking people.
Yes.
about stuff that they may or may not have done, mm-hmm. or judging mm-hmm. people based off of this. Guys, come on. It's like, let's just yes. be like love.
The only thing that I would say is be very careful out there.
Yes.
If you make those choices,
Do your research
because this is not light choices. Yeah. Like these people, you know, doctors and all this, you make sure you go to the right people, because I see how there's so much work that is botched and all this. It's like, be careful. This is not light choices. We're just saying we don't judge it. Mm-hmm. If we did it, that should be fine, even though we did not do all the things that they say. It's just be careful out there, because mm-hmm. these are not light choices. If you want to do something with your body, make sure you go to the right people that are not gonna do any harm to you, because yeah. we love you all very much and we don't want anything to happen bad.
Just okay? Do your research. It's like, you know, it's like anything in life.
Yeah,
don't take it lightly. Make a good choice.
Don't go for the cheap choice. Yeah. The these things here are very expensive. Mm-hmm. You know, we live in Hollywood, we're surrounded by that. Mm-hmm. We pretty much know what we're talking about. Just mm-hmm. Don't.
So guys, anyways, we are gonna do a bunch of more of these, because we just feel like we need to vent to you and like just kind of keep it like an open conversation and just talk. I don't know, I feel like that's so fun.
It is.
But today's the December 23rd is when we are filming this video. I think we're gonna post it today. But anyways, tomorrow's Christmas Eve. If you celebrate Christmas, Merry Christmas. We celebrate Christmas. If you do not, happy holidays, whatever you celebrate. We're sending you just lots of love and safety. And I just hope you guys are... I just hope you guys understand how much we love you. How much we appreciate you. How much we are
grateful for all this.
And how much we are here for you. Because, you know, like we said in the past, we haven't had... Both of us never really had creators or... role models to look up to have these conversations with. So we are here to have those with you. So Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, Happy mm-hmm. New Year, although we're gonna post more videos before New Year, so we'll see you soon. But anyways, mm-hmm. thank you for listening.
Thank you.
And we love you guys so much.
Love you guys. Bisous.
Bisous.